Microsoft Teams is known as a great communication tool, but it's also a powerful way to manage projects all in one place. Hey everyone, I'm Kevin, and today we'll look at how you can run a project in Teams, from organizing conversations, sharing files, all the way to tracking tasks. Let's dive in. Here I am in Microsoft Teams, and I'm on point to manage the launch of a new line of seasonal cookies here at my favorite company, the Kevin Cookie Company. This will involve lots of coordination between teams like marketing, product development, and operations, and I think Teams will be the perfect tool to manage this project. Over on the left-hand side, I'm currently in the Teams view, and right here, I see all of my existing teams. I'd like to create a new team for this project. So right up on top, we have this plus icon. Let's click on that, and we have a few different options. Let's select Create Team. I'll click on this. This opens up a prompt where we can create a new team. Now, you might be wondering, what is a team? This is a shared space where a group of people can work together. You could chat, you could share files, you could hold meetings, and you can manage tasks. And it all happens in one place. Now that sounds ideal for managing this project related to launching new cookies. Right up on top, we can give the team a name. I'll enter in the Spring Cookie Launch 2028. If you're watching this video in 2028, hello from the past. Right down below, I can also type in a description for this team. That way people know what this team is about. We're working together to create, launch, and promote our brand new line of seasonal cookies. Now right here, I could also select this team type, or basically the permissions of this team. Let's click on this. This brings us to another screen where we can define who has access and who can see this team. Up on top, I could select private, and there I could define everyone who should have access to this team. Underneath that, I could set it to public. Now it says public, but it really just means anyone in your organization. And down below, there's also an option for org-wide. That's where everyone in your organization automatically joins. That sounds pretty aggressive, and I don't want everyone in the org to have access to this. I think private is probably the right choice for me. So let's select this. At the very bottom, we can give a name to the very first channel as part of this team. Now, you might be wondering, what is a channel? It's a dedicated space within a team where you can have more focused conversations. As an example, maybe you want a separate channel for marketing, or maybe operations, or maybe product development. One way to think of it, if you're having conversations or sharing files that are only relevant to part of the team, then it makes sense to add another channel. Now, for me, I want a channel to serve as our central hub, or basically the place where all of the general coordination happens. And I'll call this main. Now, keep in mind, you can always come in later on and you could add channels. So for now, I'll type this in, and in the bottom right-hand corner, let's click on Create. Look at that, nice work. Lastly, we can also add members to this team. I don't want to work alone, so I better start adding some members. Now, right up here, you could simply type in people's names. For example, Grady should be part of this team. Let's also add Diego too. And can't forget Patty, the president. She definitely wants to have visibility into what's happening with this project. Now, right over here, you'll see a drop-down list with two different options for each member. You can be either an owner or you can be a member. An owner has full control over the team. What that means is they can add and remove other members, they can manage settings. In fact, they could even delete the entire team. With a member, on the other hand, you can participate in conversations, share files, and also collaborate. Now, I'm comfortable leaving everyone here set to a member, so I'll make sure that's set. And in the bottom right, let's click on Add. And look at that, we are making some fantastic progress. We are in our new team. Over on the left-hand side, we can see all of our different teams. And right here, we see the new team for the Spring Cookie Launch 2028. Now, this is probably one of my most important projects that I'm working on, and I'd like to place it at the top of this list. I can simply press and hold on this team, and here I can move it right to the top. That way, it'll always be top of mind. When I hover over a team, over on the right-hand side, I see these three dots with more options. And when I click on that, it opens up a context menu. Here, I could add additional members. I could also add channels. I mentioned that you could always come back in and you could add more. Well, you could do that right here. You could even get a link to this team if you'd like to send it to other people so they access this location. I'll click out of this menu. You also get a similar menu when you hover over any one of your channels. Here I'm hovering over main, and there too I could also click on more options, but I get a different set of actions that are specific to a channel. Let's click out of that. Right up on top, I also have various tabs, posts, files, and notes. Let's start with the posts tab. The posts tab is where your team can have organized conversations related to the project. Think of things like updates, or maybe questions, or feedback, and it's all here in one place. And because it's right here, it's visible to everyone who's part of the team. That way, you won't lose updates in email threads, or maybe chat threads. Let's now try creating our very first post. Right down here, let's click on this button. And here, this opens up a text field where I could type in my message. Right up on top, I could type in a subject. Let's welcome everyone to this new project team. Right down below, I could also type in my message. Here, I'll give a little bit of context for what this team's purpose is. Right up above, I have all of these different controls that allow me to format my text. And down below, I have some additional controls. I want to make sure that no one misses this message. Right down here in the bottom right-hand corner, I could select the post type. Now, by default, it's set to a standard post, but I can also make it an announcement, and that'll give this post some extra prominence. And here, I could type in a headline. Let's simply type in welcome. Then, in the bottom right-hand corner, I'll click on this button to post my post. Welcome everyone to this new project. I also think it would be a nice touch if everyone who's part of this channel could also introduce themselves. I don't think all the team members know one another. So right down here, let's start another new post. My post type is still set to an announcement since that's the last one I selected. So let's click on this and let's change it back to a post. Right here, I'll type in my message. To kick things off, let's do a quick round of introductions. Share your name, what you're working on, and maybe your favorite cookie. Now, I'm worried that people might miss this message. So to bring some extra attention to it, I can also notify everyone who's part of the channel or just individuals. Here, I could enter the @ character. And right here, I could call out specific people like Diego, Patty, or Grady. But I actually want to make sure that everyone sees this message. So instead of typing in someone specific, I could also refer to simply the entire team or just the channel. Here, if I type in main, I could reference the channel. Let me remove that. Or here, I could type in the spring cookie launch, and then I could reference the entire team. I'll select this. This way, everyone who's part of this team will get a notification that there's now a new post. I think that'll really get people to answer this message. So right down here, let's post this. On second thought, maybe instead of asking people for their favorite cookie in a message, it would make more sense to insert a poll. That way we come to consensus quicker. Let's add yet another post. I'll click on this button, and down at the bottom, we can add rich content types to our messages. First, let's add a subject right up on top. Let's say, what is your favorite new spring cookie? Then down below, let's click on this plus icon. Here, we can add all sorts of different content types to a post. For example, you can attach a file. You could also schedule when your message should send. And down below, we have all sorts of other options. For example, you could insert a stream video. You could insert a form, approvals, polls, Power BI, one of my favorites. You could even insert one of my YouTube videos. Yes, you can do that. But right here, I see an option for polls. I'll click on that one. Right up on top, I'll type in my poll question and let me put down all of the different options. Here we have the three different cookie types that we're launching. You have a few different settings that you can configure, but I think this looks good, so I'll click on preview. I think that looks good. Let's click on send. Right up above, I can now vote for my favorite cookie. Of course, it's the Lemon Lavender Delight. I'll submit my vote, and that'll aggregate all of the different vote counts down below. Let's now look at the Files tab up above. The Files tab in a Microsoft Teams channel shows all of the different shared documents, spreadsheets, and other files for this specific channel. One of the really neat things, all of these files are available to other people who are also part of this team. Also, one thing to note, if you add any files to the chat or to the posts view, they end up here in this view. Now, right up here, we could click on this new menu, and we can add a new folder if you'd like to organize your files that way. And down below, you can also create these different file types like Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and so on. Now, right here, you can also upload a file directly into this view. I want to create a flyer for this new spring cookie launch. So right here, I think a Word document would work well. Let's click on this. This opens up a prompt where I need to type in a name for this new document. I'll call it the Spring Cookie Flyer, and then let's click on Create. This drops me into a new Microsoft Word document, and I can now start composing my flyer. Now, here's the really neat thing. Other people can join and work with me on this document in real time. In fact, if we look in the top right-hand corner, we can see that Diego is currently in this document with me, which is perfect because I had a task in mind for him. Right here, I'll click on Comments, and here, I'll click on a new comment. And let me type in my message. Can you please add a quote for Patty? And I want to make sure that Diego sees this, so over here, I can at mention him in the document. I'll select Diego, and there I have my question for him. Right here, I could also assign it to Diego. I'll check this box, and let's send this comment. And look at that. Diego is a model employee. He's already responded. And right down below, I can see where he is in the document currently with this icon right down below. Now, I think this flyer is looking good, so let's now exit out of this document. Right up above, I'll close out of this tab. This drops me back into the file repository, and right here, I can see that new Word document that I created. And over on the right, I can see that Diego was the last one to modify it. When I hover over, I also get different actions related to this file. As an example, I could share this file, and if I click on the three dots, I have a lot more options right here. Now, one neat thing with this file repository, you can also add additional metadata related to all of this different content. Over here, we can add a column. Let's click on this. I want to track who owns this file. When I add a column, I have all these different options. You have text, choice, date and time, multiple lines of text, and the list goes on and on. I want to indicate the owner, so I think person makes the most sense. You can add all sorts of different metadata to your files. I'll select this and then click on next. Then up at the top, I can give this column a name. I'll simply call it owner. I could type in a description as well as other information. Let's make sure to check on show profile photos and then click on save. Right up on top, I can now see my new column. Of course, I want to populate a value in this cell. So right up on top, let's click on edit in grid view. This opens up the grid view and I can click into the owner cell. And let me type in my name, Kevin Stratvert. There I see my picture and I'm now associated with this file. This looks good. So over here, let's exit the grid view. The files view has so much power and it's really feature rich. As an example, I could click on any of these column headers, and here you could sort the different columns. You could also filter the different columns. Up in the top right-hand corner, you can also select from all of these different views. If you set a view that you like, you could even save it so it's easy to get back to that view in the future. Let's say, as an example, you just want to see all of the different files that you own, you can save that view. Now that we've looked at the files view, let's shift into the notes view up above. I'll click on this tab. This opens up a shared OneNote that everyone on the team has access to. It's basically a shared space where we can all jot down meeting minutes, ideas, or project details. That way, we all stay on the same page. Now, we have a meeting coming up and I'd like to keep track of what we discuss. So over here, I could add a new page. I'll type in today's date along with meeting notes. Now, one of my favorite tricks, over here, I'll click down into this page, and let's go up to Insert, and all the way over on the right-hand side, I'll click on these three dots, and you could insert meeting details. I'll click on this, and this will pull up all of my different upcoming meetings. So right down here, we have the late night cookie delivery expansion planning. I could click on that, and that pulls in all the details from my Outlook calendar. Now, I could add my notes to this, but it gives me all the context of when it took place, what the title was, and all of the different participants. This covers all of the default tabs that you get in a new channel, but you can also customize these tabs by adding your own. In my opinion, it's not a real project unless you have a solid way to track tasks. Right over here, let's click on this plus icon to see what we can add. Here, you'll see all sorts of different tabs that you can add to your channel. As an example, you could simply add a website URL. You could add a PDF, a whiteboard, a Visio diagram. You could also add a variety of different third-party tools, like Jira. There's even Monday.com and Trello. One of my favorites, you could add a channel calendar. And if I scroll down, you'll see all sorts of different options. Microsoft also offers its own built-in team task tracker, and it's called Planner. And that's the one I'll be using. Let's click on this. Right here, it says get organized with Planner and Teams. I could use some organization, so let's click on save. If we look right up above, you'll notice that it's now added a new tab, and everyone who's part of this team and also this channel will have access to this tab. That's perfect. That way we can all see the upcoming tasks. Right down below, let's click on create a new plan. Here, you can start with just a basic grid and board, or you could start from one of these templates. Let's go with the basic design. I'll click on this. Right down below, I can give a name. Here, I'll type in Spring Cookie Launch 2028, and then let's click on Create. This drops me into the board view, and I can now start adding tasks on the team. That way, we could start getting some work done. Right down below, let's add the very first task, finalize the Lemon Lavender Delight recipe. Over here, I could set a due date. I think we need to finish that up by the end of next week, and then I could also assign it to a person. And here I see all the different people who are part of this channel. Now, this is on Diego. I'll select him, and let's now click on Add Task, and that adds our very first task. Let's add another new task. I'll click on Add Task, and right here we need to review the cost per cookie. I could set a due date, and let's go with, let's say mid-April, and then I could also assign a person. This one's on Grady. Now, right here, let's click on Add Task. I almost forgot. I need to host a kickoff meeting. So let's click on Add Task one more time, and over here, I'll enter in Host Kickoff Meeting. For this, we should probably do this first. Let's schedule this for early next week, and then for the owner, I'll assign myself. Then let's click on Add Task, and we now have a group of three different tasks. Making some good progress. With all of the cards in Planner, you could click into a card and that shows you additional details. As an example, here you could add a label. You could assign it to a bucket. Over here, I could indicate the progress. Now, I've started thinking about it, so I think that qualifies as in progress. I'll select that. I could set the priority, and there are all sorts of other fields. Right down here, you could even set up a checklist, or basically another level of detail related to this task. Now, I'm good with all this as it is, so right up above, let's close out of this dialog. Within the board view, over here on the right-hand side, I can also filter this. So let's say, as an example, I just want to see all the different tasks that are in progress. I'll select that, and look at that, I'm the only one who's currently working. Right up above, I'll click on Clear All. You can also group the view. Here, currently it's grouped by bucket, but you could also group it by assigned to. And here I could see all of my tasks, Diego could see his, and Grady. I could click on it again. We could also group by progress, and this way you have more of a Kanban type view. As an example, Grady told me he actually already started on this analysis. I could simply take this card and let's move it over to in progress. So that way you could just move cards. If we look up above, you can also visualize all of your tasks in different ways. We've been looking at a board view, but over here I could also shift into a grid view. And there we see a nice grid showing us all of the different tasks. You could also jump into a schedule view, and that'll show you a calendar with all of the upcoming due dates. We also have charts. That way you can see somewhat of a burn down. And there are also some different premium views that you could also unlock if you go pro. Now, I said my task is in progress, so I better start working on it. One of the benefits of setting up a team and channels is it's very easy to meet with all the different members of that channel. Right up above, I see this icon, or the meet icon. Now, I could click on this dropdown and we can meet right now, but I think people would probably prefer to have a little bit of a heads up before we meet. So why don't we schedule a meeting? I'll click on this option. This opens up a new meeting invitation. Right up on top, I could type in a title for this meeting, and down below, let's type in some details for this meeting. Now, right here, I see that it's including both the team and also the channel, but I want to make sure people don't miss this kickoff meeting, so I can also send personal invites. That way, they get a meeting invitation, and hopefully, they won't miss it. I'm all set filling out the details, so up on top, let's now send this out to the channel. Now that I've set the meeting invite out, let's go back to the posts tab. And right down here at the bottom, there's now a new post announcing this meeting that's coming up. And one of the really neat things, you could actually join the meeting directly from the posts tab. And that's how you manage a project in Microsoft Teams. One task, one file, and one delicious cookie at a time. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got a Lemon Lavender Delight with my name on it. That's a real mouthful, literally. Please consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.